Have a look at this. Came across this by accident. Moby Tech security camera, 29th of May. I came across that clip by accident because my friend actually worked for a company selling security cameras, these fancy security cameras with remote control and things, and he said, oh, it's a Moby Tech camera, go and have a look at it. And I found that clip, which is taken from Munchen University. Now, does that prove that chemtrails are related to weather control? No, I don't think it does, but it's pretty interesting. Now, I'll just talk briefly, I'm really short on time now, but I think there's a connection here between Wilhelm Reich and orgone energy, because in the 1960s, he developed a device called a cloud buster, which he claimed was manipulating orgone energy. So I haven't really got much time to go into it, but basically Reich was a protege of Sigmund Freud, and he got into studying orgone energy through his studies of human sexuality. And so he sort of thought that orgone was this energy that pervades everything. And other people have come up with names that etheric energy, vacuum energy, this sort of thing. And he constructed and conducted experiments with orgone accumulators. And you can buy orgone material off websites now. So, this does seem to be a real phenomenon. People have tested and they've made motors which run off orgone accumulators. This is something that Eugene Malov was looking into, but I haven't really got time to go into all of that. And these experiments of Reich's were reproduced. You need to check into the story of Wilhelm Reich, because what he actually looked into was seemingly very dangerous, because he ended up dead in his prison cell. He died. He was found hanged in his prison cell the day before he was due to be released, which was ended up because of a contempt of court charge. But these experiments were reproduced by Charles R. Kelly in the 1960s, and he basically said that if you pointed a cloud buster at cloud, it would make the cloud go away. In other words, he verified what Reich had done. Obviously, I'm simplifying it a lot, but that's basically what he did. So experiments have been done with this, and it does seem to work. And some of you may have heard of this, which is Kate Bush's song, and it's called Cloud Busting, from the album Hounds of Love. I have got a video clip, I'll just play a very brief bit of it. Thank you. I think Kate Bush is one of these people that knows what's going on. That's just a feeling I get. She's a bit of a recluse, as you probably know. She wrote the song about this book, A Book of Dreams, which was by Peter Reich, which is Wilhelm Reich's son, which told some of the story of Wilhelm Reich and what happened to him. You can get a copy of that book for second hand for 40 quid, or if you want to get a new one, it's 135 quid. So it's out of print, obviously. Now, I'm not going to talk about HAARP much. People commonly link HAARP and chemtrails. Is there a connection? Short answer, I don't know. I've got a video clip about that, but I'll skip over that. Some very strange things to do with HAARP, and people have connected it to the Haiti quake as well, which is quite interesting. It does seem to be some data that it was on just before the Haiti quake. I'm not sure. Nick Begich talks a lot about HAARP, but he also believes the official story of 9/11. I've got an audio clip of him, which makes him very suspect in my eyes, because he supports the bombing of Afghanistan in this clip. Seems a bit strange. Chem busters, I mentioned that briefly. You can download how to make your own chem buster. Now then, another quick look at is hurricane manipulation. We've already talked about that in Project Storm Fury, but here's, I've got another audio clip here. Again, we're coming to the end now. So this, you can see these bands of rain from, this is from Hurricane Ophelia. What's causing these linear bands of rain? And we've seen this in a couple of hurricanes. You can go and download these from various websites. So we move on. Now, a lot of people have attempted to cover up this information, including people that I know. Very few people are aware of this that's on your screen now. I've had to write a book in relation to this. This is the hurricane that was parked in the Atlantic on 9/11. Closest to New York City at 8 o'clock in the morning. How many people have heard of that before? Not many people nodding. This is from the research of Dr. Judy Wood. This is the plume of material. I don't say smoke. It's not smoke. Material from the World Trade Center on the same picture. Got a pentacle in the eye. How very strange. Where is Erin on the morning forecast? Two of the stations mentioned it, two of them didn't. I've got a separate video about that. Should be there. One of them said rough seas. They basically didn't talk about it. Skip over that. No, I'm going to skip over all this. That's the path. Starts on the 1st of September. Went to Bermuda. It was logged at Bermuda. It caused some damage at Bermuda. Then CNN said, going out to sea, nothing to worry about. Yeah, damn right, went out to sea. Closest to New York at 8 o'clock in the morning, made a right-hand turn. Went out to Newfoundland the next day. Just a coincidence, though, nothing to worry about. Nothing to worry about. Now, just briefly mention this, because I don't have time to go into all these. I've got a two-hour presentation about all of this separately. This is particularly interesting here at 8:46 in the morning. This is the magnetometer data found by Dr. Judy Wood at the University of Alaska. That's where the data was, not where Dr. Judy Wood was. Exactly 8:46 on 9/11. We've got the Earth's magnetic field dipping in one direction. I'm not sure whether it's north or south. Precisely 8:46, we have this minimum. And that's exactly the same time as the supposed first plane hit the World Trade Center. Not only that, but the Earth's magnetic field anticipated the plane crash for 20 minutes before it happened. How can that happen? You want my answer? It wasn't a plane that caused the hole in the World Trade Center. That was not a plane. Now, I've got a lot more on this. I'm coming up to the end. I've got another video from Ben Fulford. Just want to mention this statement from William Cohen. Talks of weather control in 1997. Other terrorists are engaging even in an eco-type of terrorism whereby they can alter the climate, set off earthquakes, volcanoes, remotely through the use of electromagnetic waves. Very interesting phrase. So there are plenty of ingenious minds out there at work, including finding ways in which they can wreak terror upon other nations. It's real, and that's the reason why we have to intensify our counter-terrorism efforts. Or is it, William Cohen, that you're telling us what the group that you're connected with is going to do to us? I suspect that's what it is. What you're looking at, I think, is a result of black projects, classified programs done by the secret team, the shadow government, whatever you want to call them. Their existence is always officially denied. We can't take the issue of climate change seriously without taking into account what you've been shown today, because any conclusions that are drawn will be irrelevant. Okay? So all this stuff about the Hatfield Research Centre that's happened in the last few months, if you've been reading up on that, that's just a sideshow. There is some group that's able, I contend, to steer hurricanes, make them do things. I think we saw that happen at New Orleans as well. And until that is looked at, until the chemtrails are looked at, forget it. I'm not interested in anything else. So scientists who refuse to look at this evidence and evaluate its validity will come to the wrong conclusions. It's as simple as that. So we have to expose these, talk about this chemtrailing that's going on. It is real. It is affecting the weather in some way, if only on the short term. But you're going to have to fight for the truth if you want it. It's a hard journey. Now, again, I'd just like to mention I've got DVDs. People want to ask me further questions. I've missed a lot of stuff out. That's basically it, though. And thank you very much indeed for listening.